Okay, so I'm gonna do a quick video of this home. I'm not gonna go through the inside. So this is a solid home. I'm gonna explain a few things to you about how structurally sound this house is. The roof is around 3 years old. So what if I miss anything in this, it's gonna be obviously in the report section. So first and foremost, okay, so there's a load-bearing wall here and a load-bearing wall here. You'll see it's the two walls in the living room. Behind, underneath those walls is a full cripple wall with its own stem footing foundation going from one end of the perimeter to the other end. You never see this on an old house like this. Usually most houses are like this, are post and pier or inch and an eighth subfloor going four foot on center girder. So that is huge. I mean, that's a structurally huge thing to see, because what it is that the distribution from the load bearing is at 16 inches on center instead of the span of the girder to the column. So it's a much better distribution of weight and much more structurally sound. There's ridge cap on ridge vent on the top of the ridge on a hip. So I ran my thermal reader to do distribution of the temperature difference between the sheathing and the ridge vent to the upper ceiling lid, and there's like a 40 degree difference, so that's pretty good. Hip and valleys usually just always have a little bit less ventilation than gable ends, just because gable ends usually have a four point ventilation distribution. So usually on gables you have the e-vent, gable vent, ridge vent, and roof vent. So actually it's 3 point, sorry, let me rephrase that. It's usually always 3 point, sometimes it's 4 point. Ridge vent is actually a new concept, so they haven't been doing that for more than 10 years. So you'll see this, if you walk up, when you're walking towards it, you'll see this dip right here. And you'll be like, oh my gosh, it's something wrong here. Actually, no. The dip is for a reason. There's a scup drain here, and that's so the top of this porch cover does not flood. So water goes from this valley runoff too, and it goes right to that scup drain, which goes through this gutter. I walked it. I can't tell, but I believe the cantilever, this goes past here and goes right to the roof end, but I kind of doubt it because it is lower. So I believe it ends right here and it's tied in, which technically would make it not code, because for 1/3 cantilever, you need 2/3 support. But it wasn't falling down, but it's not leaning because it's falling down. It's leaning because of pitch to the drain, which is, I'll show you right here. You see that? That's your drain. So it's pitching for a reason, for water runoff, so it doesn't pond. It's not pitching because of weight. It's pitching because it's meant to be that way. So if you want to, you can always put a 4x4 pressure treated and tie to the fascia board, or possibly if you can find this joist right here, and go down and redhead a 4x4 galvanized post anchor right there. But you do not want to push this up. You just want to just touch it. You don't want to cause any problems to this, because you want to make sure it has that pitch. Obviously the top of its railing is all rotted. Okay, let's keep going. So the siding is actually, it's shiplap, and I'm not too worried. Some of it's just got some dry rot, but it's expected, especially for the age of the home. You don't have to caulk all these because it's actually shiplap and they're interconnected. So even if they're open like this, it's still watertight. But if you want to caulk it just for aesthetic reasons, that's fine. We're just gonna go around. I'm not gonna do the garage too much. Just doing a quick video of the important thing. So, new panel box. I did test everything. Good to go. Roof is, like I said, this roof is about 3 years old, so you're good. Okay, so you see that crack right there? That is not a concrete crack. That is a stucco veneer crack. So there's a veneer, they put like a stucco veneer on this concrete, not over here, but just on this area. So I'm wondering if that was originally, because this used to be a patio cover, and just this was actually turned into a room, a bonus room, you can call it. So that is not a structural crack. So that's the only thing that's cracked right there is actually the stucco crack. I checked the chimney, it's all flashed properly. Rain cap, spark arrestor is correct. Let me see. I believe that outlet, one of these outlets has an is not properly operating, so they replaced the GFI. This is funny. So this is something a home inspector get wrong on every time. And someone who doesn't understand residential building codes would understand this. So that tread to ground level is less than 30 inches. It's actually 29 inches, which means it does not require a railing. And residential building code, I think it's 3121, I have to look it up again, actually overrides standards of practices. So you don't need 4-inch balusters. You don't even need a railing here at all. The only thing it would require is a handrail because you have more than 4 risers, which it has that. But no, this is fine. You don't have to have 4-inch spaces. This is perfectly fine. You don't even need this railing because it's less than 30 inches from ground to tread level. That is, residential building code will always override standards of practice because it's code. Code is code. Standards of practice is just an opinion or something where home inspectors use because they don't understand code. Like I said, I went underneath the crawl space, and this is the cripple wall member that this whole foundation wall right here actually spans all the way to the front. And this one too, let me see, is it, I think it's over here somewhere. I think it's right there, spans too. This is the living room. Yeah, because, what it is that's a full, like I said, that's one of the best features of this house. I'll explain in the report. Distributes the dead load 16 inches on center instead of going post and girder. This is obviously a new packaged unit, newer. I ran the thermal reader and the thermal gun and tested all your ducting. There's no leaks or anything. There's only one vent I couldn't get to because it was underneath a bunch of stuff in the living room. So I don't think it's a big deal. Okay, and a lot of this, you'll see a lot of the dry rot, or I'll show you. I mean, it's over on the other side. I would leave that up just to the pest inspector to give you a number on repairs for that. This is can get sanded down too. I think this is not too bad. It's just surface. Okay, let me think. You got gutter covers on all your gutters. The heater's disconnected, so I didn't run that. Which obviously you really don't need that. Well, it's just in the bonus area. So, which I called the office. Okay, there's some more surface, peeling, I guess you can call it, of the paint. If I miss anything, like I said, I'm gonna have in the report. I'm gonna go this way real quick. And I'll be done. Oh, I didn't even put this in the report. That sucks. Just gonna want to have to paint. You're gonna want to paint the overhang. Two of these outlets are there or have an open ground. Trying to figure out the plexiglass. It's not properly flashed or anything. So, but it's just, again, it's a storage building. I think the overhang is long enough that you shouldn't have too much water intrusion from the roof, at least. Here's some of the damaged stucco. Shiplap, which you can replace. They have that standard, pretty standard to find. But then again, for the age of the house, it's just unbelievably. This is just an amazing house. I mean, I'm blown away, actually. I think I was spent more time on this just being shocked how well it was built than anything else. And well, the owner took really good care of it, so this is definitely a really, 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 really good house. All right, well, that is it with my video. If I miss anything, it's going to be on the report. Thank you.